Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Here are some tips and tricks for taking screenshots on your iPhone. So capturing a screenshot on your iPhone is pretty straightforward. On most modern iPhones, there's a side button and you just hold both the side button and the volume up button and you get a screenshot. It shows at the lower left-hand corner, and if you wait a few seconds, that disappears and the screenshot is now saved in your Photos app. But there's a lot more functionality there. For instance, if you were to take the screenshot and then instead tap on the floating thumbnail at the bottom, you now come to a screen where you have lots of different controls. If instead of saving this to the Photos app, you instead want to do something else with it, then just tap the share button at the upper right-hand corner. Now you have the ability to share it in various different ways. For instance, you can send it via messages or mail to someone, or you could save it to a note. There's a lot more you can do if you scroll up and to the right in this list of icons. In fact, you can tap the More button here, and you can customize which apps are shown here. Tap Edit, and you could add items to the Favorites list and then reorder them so the one used the most is the furthest to the left. Likewise, if you scroll down this list, you'll see Edit Actions here, and you can add other actions, mostly things you create in the Shortcuts app, to this list. But there's another way to share that allows you to skip the thumbnail and editing interface. If you take the screenshot, and instead of just a quick tap on the floating thumbnail, you tap and hold for 2 seconds, and then release, it goes directly to the share sheet. So you skip that entire thing. You can still get back to all the controls by tapping X and it goes back to a floating thumbnail. Then a quick tap there brings you into the full interface. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now there are other ways to take screenshots as well. For instance, you can go into settings here and then go to accessibility. And then look for touch. And at the bottom of the list of touch options is back tap. Go into that and you've got a double tap and a triple tap. So let's turn the double tap back tap into a way to take screenshots. I could just select it from the list here. So now to take a screenshot, I just tap lightly with one finger on the back of my iPhone and it will take the screenshot. If you go back up to the top of the touch controls here, and you go to assistive touch, if you turn this on, then you get this dot on your screen. I'm going to turn off my mouse here and you'll be able to see it. There it is at the bottom right. If I tap that, it opens a menu and you can see there, well, I've got it set to single tap, open menu. But I can change that to simply take a screenshot. So I can basically add a screenshot button. So now when I tap that, and you can see it there at the bottom right, it will take the screenshot like that. Notice it doesn't include the button there in the screenshot. Note you could also set it to a double tap or a long press on that button. And if you have single tap set to open a menu, then you'll get a menu that looks like this. You can actually change what each of these buttons do. So I can change the upper right-hand button there to be a screenshot button, for instance. In that case, it will take 2 taps to actually get the screenshot done. But I also have all these other buttons that I could set up. And there's another way to take a screenshot using Siri. Just ask Siri to do it. Take a screenshot. Now, one of the problems I mentioned with taking a screenshot is that it's saved to your Photos library, which may not be where you want it. After all, I know I just want my photos in my Photos library. I don't want to save screenshots there. So you have some options. One of those is to tap the share button here, and then use copy. And this will copy the screenshot to the clipboard. Now it takes you back to the interface here, but with the screenshot now on the clipboard, I could just tap the trash icon there and then delete the screenshot. And now I can go into another app like in Mail here, and I can just paste, and it'll paste the screenshot in. If you'd rather save the screenshot as a file, you can do that as well. So tap the share button here, and then scroll down. And one of the options you'll see here is Save to Files, meaning the Files app. So you go in there and then you have your whole Files app interface for navigating to where you want to save something. So for instance, here in my documents folder, I have created a screenshots folder for holding these screenshots. I can go in here and save it here. And then when I'm done with that, I can use trash and delete screenshot. But there's another way to copy to the clipboard or save as a file, and that's to simply tap the done button. And notice that then you get several options here. The first is to save to photos, as would have been done automatically if we didn't even go into this interface. You can also save to files. You can save to a note, and you can simply copy and delete, or just delete the screenshot without doing anything with it. So I can use copy and delete, and now it's quickly gone away, and I've got it in the clipboard ready to paste into another app. But there's yet another way to actually share a screenshot with an app or to save it to files. Take the screenshot, and then instead of tapping or tapping and holding for 2 seconds, tap and drag. And notice you can drag the screenshot around. Let's say I want to add it to a note. With another finger, I can tap on notes, and then I can go into a note, and I could drop it here. Or I could have gone into the Files app. I can actually just move over the Files app, and you see how it opens automatically, and now I could drop it here into Files. And now I'm not bothered with that entire interface at all. It just goes into the Files app at this location and doesn't give me the interface. I don't have to take extra steps to dismiss it or delete the screenshot so it doesn't save to photos. Now, so far, I've just talked about actually saving the screenshot as is. There's a lot you can do when you're in this interface before you save the screenshot. Notice that this box around it has these handles on the sides, top and bottom, and the corners. You can use this to crop the screenshot. So you don't have to save the entire screen. You could just save a portion of it. And even after you've cropped, you can drag up or down or left or right to add more back to what you want to save. Note, you can also use two fingers here and pinch in or out to crop in that way. Another thing that you can do with a screenshot is instead of dealing with it as an image, you can copy text from it. You've got this little button here at the bottom right. Tap that and it will find any text that it can in the image. So even if you couldn't select text in something, like in some app, and the text wasn't selectable, you could take a screenshot and then in the screenshot use this text tool and you can now copy the text like that and then paste it into another document. Now, of course, you can mark up your screenshots before you do anything with them as well. So if I take a screenshot here and I go into the regular screenshot interface, it's this tool here that allows me now to have all of the pens, and I can tap the plus button here and add shapes and text and stickers and all sorts of things to this screenshot before I then do other things with it. A special feature of screenshots in Safari is this interface here at the top where it shows screen and full page. If I select full page, now I get a screenshot of the entire page, not just the portion that was visible on the screen. So now if I save it, I get this really long JPEG, but I could also choose the cropping tool here and crop only to a certain section of the page like that. If you want to get a screenshot of something that's hard to grab because there's an animation or something going on, one way to do it is to use screen recordings instead and then grab a screenshot from that. So I'm going to use Control Center here at the top right and start a screen recording, like say when the icons are wiggling or something like that. And I'm going to tap here, stop that screen recording like that, and it's going to save into Photos. So I'll go into Photos now and then I'll pause it and get to the frame I want, like say right here. And now if I just do a light tap in the middle, notice all the interface stuff goes away. And I can do an additional screenshot like this, and I've got a screenshot of something that would have been hard to grab otherwise. Let's say you want to take a series of screenshots and then combine them together in a PDF. You can do that. I'll assume that you save the screenshots to several files in the Files app. So I've got, say, three here. So in the Files app, I can tap on the three dots button and select, and I'll select these three screenshots like that. And then I'm going to go to Share, and you may not see any way to save this as a PDF. But if you go to print, it'll show you the three items here and that it's going to print three pages. Instead, take two fingers and pinch out right here in the preview. And you can see it says one of three up here, but there's also a share button here. If I share this, it's going to save a PDF. That PDF file will have those three screenshots embedded in it. And one of the disappointing things about screenshots is how many steps it takes. Sometimes it would be nice just to take a screenshot and have it saved as a file in one step. But you actually can do that. The trick is to use a shortcut. In the Shortcuts app here, I've created a shortcut called Screenshot to File. If I go to that, all it is the Take Screenshot action and then the Save File action right after it. And it's immediately going to link the screenshot as to what to save. And then here for the location, I actually selected this. It originally went to Shortcuts, a folder in iCloud Drive, but instead I changed it to go to the same screenshots folder we were looking at before. Under Options here, I turned off Asked Where to Save, although you certainly can leave that on and then save each screenshot individually. But instead, I set a subpath that is the current date variable, and I set it to a custom date format. You can see it here below. So year-month-day, and then hours, minutes, seconds with no dividers between them. And now that I've got a shortcut, that will instantly save a screenshot with no options or actions or anything. I can assign that to something, like for instance, back in accessibility under touch, I can assign that shortcut to a double tap back tap. So here I can choose from the list at the bottom from shortcuts here, that screenshot to file like that. And now a quick back tap will take the screenshot and save it to the Files app right here. And you can see it added it there. If you have an iPhone 16 or the iPhone 15 Pro with the action button, you could assign a shortcut to the action button and then have that button simply take a screenshot and instantly save it as well. And of course, you can create your own shortcuts to do various different things. Like for instance, just copying to the clipboard instead of saving to a file. There's a lot you can do with a screenshot shortcut. Hope you found these tips useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.